Sir, I actually played Call of Duty and War. War never changes, sir.
No, no, no!
Was that Fallout? I take it you've also watched the Fallout teaser? I have not yet, but I am very excited to watch the Fallout teaser, actually.
I know that I've lived a relatively comfortable life.
Stop! Mercy!
Now that's a fucking universe, baby. Fallout, oh my god, this is a fucking universe right here.
You need to go home. Vault dwellers are an endangered species. I do not think you would be willing to do what it takes to survive up here. If you insist on staying, then you will have to adapt.
Oh god. The studio behind The Boys in free 2-day shipping. If Amazon wasn't such a fucking monstrous corporation, that would be a funny ass line, but it's just like, eh. Also,
I don't want,
but this does look cool.
Tomorrow, so they say.
Yeah, it'll be like ultra violent for sure.
A bright new sun will suddenly break through. But I don't.
I mean, this is, for me, this was like, when I found out Walter Goggins is in this as a fucking ghoul bounty hunter, I was like, oh, that's it. It's over. It's Jover. There's no way you can fuck this up. Bro's a Fallout character. Yeah, he looks like a ghoul, dude. Come on, dude. He is the GOAT. He is so good.
Won't you see tomorrow?
He's so fucking good, dude.
Unless I see it with you.
And grabbed a moldy one.
Oh my god. And also, yo, before I forget, motherfucking Twin Peaks Andy over here too. That's crazy. Kyle MacLaughlin. Looks like a YouTube series, Smosh type shit. We'll see. We'll see what happens. I, you know, I'm not in the business of getting sad before something comes out. I don't know the background, though. Is it based off of, which Fallout is it based off of? Like, what is it based off of? House of Dragon teaser next, please. That I don't care about as much. It's 4. I've never played the games, but I'm watching the show purely based on the hyper-realistic portrayal of bombs hitting cities, nuclear bombs hitting cities. Yeah. Fallout is great. It's a great story. Apparently, it will take things out of New Vegas in 4, but it'll be an original story. If it takes things out of New Vegas, it's probably one of the best. That's one of the best stories to take things out of. But yeah. There's a really good unofficial Fallout series made by fans on YouTube, by the way. What? This is 12 years ago, man. That's crazy.
Track and return the
slave known as Scarlet to her respective owners in New Vegas. Should you encounter the ghoul...
Chatters will literally be like, dude, oh my god, this Amazon Prime Studio show fucking is ass cheeks and it looks fucking fake and shitty and cheap. And then we'll be like, here, watch this YouTube YouTube fan-made content from 12 years ago.
Wait. What if we give you the additional bonus to not kill us?
That sounds pretty good. Would you just shoot him, please?
Is that Steven Crowder? I don't want to sound... Is that Steven Crowder?
Okay, wait.
Oh, it's not.
Good. Would you just shoot him?
Like, when he goes, that sounds pretty good. Like, right here, I'm like, that's Steven Crowder.
Pretty good. Would you just shoot him, please?
I don't want to set the world on
That's
fire.
So funny. They, like, CGI was not even...
I just want to start a place.
What the hell was that? You guys missed.
Sounds dangerous.
Oh, we probably should have shot him when they went for their weapons.
That's what we opened with. That was our thing.
This is from 2010, man. Like... They're doing their fucking best, okay? I'm surprised they haven't said the N-word yet. All right? Chill out. It's just like, this is a YouTube video from 2010, okay? Yeah, F-slur incoming, okay? Straight up. Well, the channel was awesome. They taught at home SFX for film. In Todd we trust is what many are saying. I don't trust him as far as I can throw him. Right, but everybody knows I hate Todd Howard because he's white. Todd Howard has lost all.
Hey everyone, thank you so much for joining us today,
like,
and welcome
respect
to
and
Bethesda Game Studios.
Good faith that
you know,
people had
so
in himself.
Lucky.
I saw you know in Todd we trust. Don't believe his lies. He immediately started the conversation by showing you feelings of nostalgia as to why you're supposed to trust him. Like, look, Fallout. Look at that. Look at how good that was. Look at how good that made you feel. Think about how good these games make you feel when you were younger and you really enjoyed them.
Obviously, we've come a long way since then with the games we've built, our technology, and all of us here in this.
It cut out before 76. Yo, I was just kidding, but dude. No, literally, dude, he's doing the thing. He's doing the thing that I just said he's doing.
Obviously, with
look, dude,
a long way since then. With the games we've built, our technology,
it literally cuts off right as you can see it, like it flashes it a little bit.
You'll be a believer by the end. I already want to believe.
Starfield is our first new universe,
bro. Listen to me, I'm such a fucking slut for anything, any kind of new IP. I don't give a shit, okay? I don't give a fuck if he's the biggest liar. I'm still going to buy it. I'm still going to play it. And maybe I'll be disappointed, but I'm not going to be disappointed. I'm going to go in and I'm going to love it, okay?
This game is a reflection of the incredible and passionate team that made it.
Damn, dude. Y'all ride that dick. I mean, I do too, but at least the dick I'm riding is like Hideo Kojima's dick. You know what I mean?
All of them putting something special of themselves into it.
I
so
ride
let's hear some of their favorite moments.
I ride the best dick, okay? Kojima and Miyazaki. Those are the dicks I ride because they've never actually led me astray. You guys are riding the dick of white men, okay? White men that have lied to you in the past. They've lied to you, and they've led you astray, and they've hurt your feelings, and you're still riding it.
Moments.
Stop saying Death Stranding. Death Stranding was fine.
I love the way.
Like, you can't compare Death Stranding to fucking Fallout 76. You know what I mean? Can you? Do you think it's comparable? Be honest. In your heart of hearts. That's not fair. No, that's like... You're comparing... You're saying that Kojima's... is not rideable in the, or you're comparing it that way. Nobody can compare Metal Gear Solid 5 to Fallout 76. No, you can't. No. Absolutely not. Also, That's one is literally like indentured servitude, okay? Versus the other guy has like way more leeway with the business decisions on the side, okay? I see Metal Gear Solid 5 as like Kojima being held at gunpoint to like make a game again. And even then, you can't compare it because Metal Gear Solid 5 is still like literally an objectively good game. It's not Metal Gear Solid 3 because you're comparing it to one of the greatest games of all time. I don't agree with that assessment. I love Bethesda games. You guys already know. I started my Bethesda journey with Morrowind. I am a bit of an unapologetic fanboy to a certain degree, even though I'm not the biggest fan and have been wronged before by Todd. Personally, he's wronged me personally. He both personally wronged me. Constellation spacesuit removed. What is happening? Why are my space helmets being removed? What? Did this steal my helmet? I bought it. Todd heard you and he took my fucking helmet. Bitch, give me my helmet back, Todd. Todd. Todrick.
It just feels like Fallout 3, but in space. It does. And that's a good thing. That's not a bad thing.
It's not optimized at all. Todd Howard is fucking out of his mind for saying, just upgrade your PC. I have one of the best PCs that you can currently purchase on the market. Right? Like, literally. So, yes, Todd Howard is fucking dumb for saying, just upgrade your PC.
Another piece of shit from the ass of Todd Howard, then?
No, it's... Dude, listen, if you like world building, if you like immersive, expansive universes where you can do a ton of stuff, Bethesda tinted glasses, no, Bethesda just makes a very specific type of game that appeals to fucking boomers. That's it, man. You won't understand it unless you were there when fucking Morrowind came out. You know what I mean? Like, it's a very specific type of game where, like, all these different guilds and all the politics that's interwoven into the story is, like, a lot of fun. If you don't like that, if you find that to be boring, then yeah, you're not going to like it. You know, that's it. That's it. That's why I was there. I love that shit. That's why it's like, I know Todd Howard sucks, or I know he lies and tells sweet little lies. But overall, it's like, you know, I'll take it. I'll eat that garbage. I'll eat that garbage all day, every day, because I'm a fucking crackhead. I'm a fucking crackhead for all the, like, the fun little... Dude, let me tell you something, okay? Just, if you play, and this is, like, super fucking... Like, this was, like, 20 hours into my gameplay, at least. Like, when you get to the Crimson Fleet missions, like, you're like, oh, my God, this is so much fun. That's it. Like, it's so sick. It's just so good. It's so much fun. It's, like, typical classic Bethesda where you're like, fuck, this is great. And it's great. It really is great. Faction quests are fucking better than the main quests, and I'll stand by that.
Guess what? Fucking pronouns! No. Current fucking day!
Pronouns don't current fucking day us! The only argument that you can make towards me being transphobic is that I do not play Hearts of Iron or Fallout New Vegas.
What's this, what's stopping these guys from just, like, playing Fallout? Like, getting it out of their system? Like, I don't... Or do they do that as well?
No, if they started playing Fallout, then they'd play New Vegas and turn trans. That's how it works. That's how they're trans in our youth and now our elderly. What's stopping? I mean, dude, it's just they want to play Fallout in real life. That's what it is. They love LARPing. It's like analog. They have to do it analog. Yeah. Oh, she's pressing buttons. Calm down. No. Anyway, guys, love you all, and I will see you tomorrow. Bye.